Hello. Happy 4th of July and welcome to Nature Walks with Kent. This episode won't have much walking. I'm here at Naperville River Walk. I've done some walking already. And I'm here for a Carillon concert that's due to start in about 6 minutes. I thought while we're waiting for it, I'll give you a little tour. Let's flip it around here. And you can see the Carillon. And there's a sign over here that gives you a little history. And it gives you a little diagram of the tower. The observation deck is at 135 feet, open air observation deck that's usually open, but it's closed now for COVID-19. It's 160 feet tall. The playing cabin is up here. Playing cabin. Millennium Carillon has 72 bells. There's a gallery, an atrium, the tower entrance at the bottom, performance area. There's an elevator in there, stairway. There's a big bell. Okay, there are 72 bronze bells cast by the Royal, I would not be able to pronounce that, Ejbu, maybe, bell foundry in the Netherlands. The bells range in weight from 10 pounds to 5.8 tons. Total weight of the bells is 32 and a half tons. The largest bell is dedicated to Captain Joseph Naper, Naperville's founder, and it's known as Big Joe. The Carillon instrument is located on three levels of Moser Tower. There's a lower belfry with 10 mammoth bells, the player's cabin, and an upper belfry with 62 bells. The Carillon strikes the hours from 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. and plays several songs on the automatic play system during the day. Live recitals are often performed during the day as well. Hopefully we're going to hear one of those in a few minutes. The bells of a Carillon are always fixed and do not swing. The instrument is played by using a keyboard called a clavier, which pulls the bell clappers against the side of each bell via a series of direct mechanical linkages. All of the bells in the Millennium Carillon are donated generously by families or community service groups, including the JCs and the Rotary Club. Tower factoids. The four piers of Moser Tower were designed to represent the core values of Naperville: family, education, community, and commerce. Even though the four piers appear to taper, each one is perfectly perpendicular to represent the fact that these four values never waver, but stand upright and strong. 70 tons of structural steel was used in constructing the tower. Over 800 cubic yards of concrete were used to build the foundations, floor areas, terrace, and performance area risers. The tower's foundations are grounded in limestone bedrock. 185 individual precast stone pieces were used to construct the four tower piers and roof. Each piece required the construction of a separate mold crafted in a specially built carpenter shop set up at the manufacturer's plant in Wisconsin. And then over here, they have a statue that was put up in honor of the people who this tower was named after, the Mosers. Mr. and Mrs. Naperville was their nickname. Very interesting sculpture. You see the tree there represents nature. They were big naturalists. The church. Another building. He has a shovel. He was a real estate developer. There's a plaque on the back here. Margaret and Harold Moser. Mr. and Mrs. Naperville. They played vital roles in the growth and development of Naperville during the 20th century. Clearly a self-made man, Harold, along with his wife, was grounded in the belief that giving back to their community was essential to creating a quality place to live. Well, the concert's due to start in about a minute, so I'm going to make my way back over to my shady spot, and we'll listen. 2:59. Should be starting soon. Supposed to start at 3:00. There are some people here, but not a lot. Very easy to stay socially distant. Thanks for coming. Jim, I think you and Frank are the only ones watching right now. Glad you called.
I'm way too close.
I think that might be it. It's hard to tell when it ends. Kind of looks like it. Well, I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did. Happy 4th of July, everybody. And be safe. God bless.